people who have given their hard-earned money to churches only to find that whenever they were in need, whether it may be financial or they or their loved ones were sick and in the hospital and nobody from the church came to check up on them, nobody visited them, nobody called them, and this has left them bitter, angry, and disappointed with church. And so today I just want to give you a few things to consider when dealing with church hurt. Number one, be careful not to allow a negative church experience to cause you to drift away from God. Whenever you experience church hurt, you will be strongly tempted to just throw up your hands and say, you know what, God, I am through with church and I am through with you. God invites us in his word and he says, call on me in the day of trouble. And so if you're going through a season where you're not really regularly going to church, it's in these times when you have to be extra intentional to draw even closer to God in Bible study, in prayer, and in worship. Because if you do not do this, I promise you, you will find yourself quickly drifting away from God. Number two, extend grace to your leaders. So what ends up happening is we end up putting pastors and leaders up on such a high pedestal that whenever they disappoint us, we are crushed. We have to understand that they are human too, and so depending on the size of the church, there's a good chance that they could have easily overseen an email, a text message, or a request for help. So we must always remember that even though we were hurt by a church, it very well may not have been their intent to do so. Number three, don't judge all churches by one church. It's so interesting to me that whenever we get hurt in our romantic relationships, we somehow find enough courage to jump into another one. And if it's a good relationship, we're glad that we did, because if we hadn't done it, then we could have easily missed out on the person that God had for us. In the same way, no matter how many negative church experiences that you may have had, I want to encourage you to continue to try to find the right church for you. Pray and use wisdom and ask God to lead you to the right church, because if you don't, you could very well be short-circuiting your own blessings. Number four is huge, and that is to bring it to the church's attention. The Bible says to speak the truth in love, and so as difficult as it is, and no matter how long ago it is, the only way that that church is going to improve is if we find enough courage to sit down with the leaders and clearly communicate our disappointment with them. When you do that, you are not only expediting the healing process in your own life, but you are making that church aware so that somebody else down the line will not have to experience the same pain that you did. Number five is a tough one, and that is to resist the urge to speak negatively about that church or that church leader. And so whenever we are bitter, angry, and frustrated with a church, it's easy for us to find ourselves slandering the church or slandering the leader and speaking negatively about that person to someone else who may be interested in going to that church. And as a result, without even knowing it, the enemy is using us to cut off and short circuit the blessing that God may want to do in and through that person's life in that church.